Discovering hidden things in a movie is great. It's a bit like when you have a Kinder surprise. You've eaten the chocolate, enjoyed it, and then you get the second wave of joy when you remember you can now build a toy. Unlike this sweet treat, however, films aren't always so forthcoming with their secrets. In fact, sometimes they're deliberately hidden to try and up the ante even further. If it's not that obvious and you still manage to track it down, you're gonna feel as satisfied as you do after, well, you know. Let's keep this PG. I'm Simon from Whatculture, and this is 10 Devilishly Clever Movie Secrets You Probably Missed. Number 10, Mickey Mouse is in Aladdin. Disney is obsessed with Mickey Mouse. Obsessed! It gets kinda creepy the more you dive into it, but it's hard to deny how popular the guy is. Try and find someone who doesn't recognize him. He's arguably the most iconic mascot in the world. Which is even weirder because he's literally a giant rodent. This love goes deeper than you may imagine though, as Disney is always keen to sneak Mickey into movies he has no place being. They don't even do it obviously either, meaning the sole purpose is to get people talking, much as we're doing now. But if you freeze frame Aladdin at the right point, when Raja the tiger is being transformed back into his original state after Jafar had whooped his ass, you'll see two mouse-like ears coming out of his head. Why? Because Mickey Mouse runs the world. You didn't even realize. Number 9. There's a Simpsons reference in Godzilla. Way back before you were born, or 1998, a terrible, terrible Godzilla movie was released. That's all you need to know. It was really bad, and Matthew Broderick spends most of his time acting annoyed instead of scared. Like it's really screwed up his day that this giant dinosaur has come to destroy the Earth.
Wrong floor.
It does have its highlights though, the biggest of all of these being the name of one of the film's taxi drivers. Flashed up briefly on the man's ID card, it simply reads Armin Tamzarian, or the real name of the Simpsons Principal Skinner. Weird, right? Well, kinda. It loses a bit of mystery when you learn that both Hank Azaria and Harry Shearer, who voice for the Simpsons, also star in the movie. Still though, I like it. Number 8. Bob Kane gets name-checked in Batman. No one ever seems to remember that Bob Kane created Batman. And to be fair, there's a lot of chat that says he actually didn't, and it was the idea of someone else. But that's not for now. Go and debate that in your own time. During Tim Burton's 1989 Batman, however, the director did decide to pay his respects to the man many cite as being responsible for the Dark Knight's existence. When reporter Alexander Knox is handed a mock sketch of the Bat, who no one believes is real, the signature on the bottom simply reads, Bob Kane. So there you go. Years before Stan Lee threw himself into every Marvel movie, Kane here was pulling all the strings. Number 7. There's Morse code in King Kong. When Peter Jackson decided to take on King Kong, only one thing was for certain. It was gonna be long. And man, was it long. In fact, that entire first act could have just been cut out. But I digress. Clearly wanting to make sure everything in the movie made some sort of sense, Jackson and his team even sneaked in some rogue Morse code. You know, just in case there were people sat in the cinema dying to test out their skills. When the ship is on its way to Skull Island, though, it's reported that they've received genuine Morse code for Carl Denham's arrest. That's not actually what it says, mind. Instead, the message would read, Show me the monkey, because of Jerry Maguire.
Show me the monkey!
And King Kong is a monkey. Forget it. Number 6. E.T. takes place in the Star Wars universe. This is one that gets people going, and you all have Star Wars Episode 1 to blame for it. And to be fair, that film deserves a lot of blame. During one of Queen Amidala's long, drawn-out, boring speeches, there's three aliens standing on a platform who are basically E.T. Like, so much so, if George Lucas and Steven Spielberg weren't friends, Spielberg would have been on the phone instantly. But therein lies the point. They are buddies, and after Steve had dropped in Star Wars references to E.T., George wanted to reciprocate. And he did. Number 5. Anchorman characters dine out in dives. We all know that Anchorman is a classic. It's funny, insane, layered so you can watch it again and again. It was made that way. But man, did they get carried away with some of the jokes. So much so, that you need to speak Spanish to get them. When Veronica Corningstone is seen eating in a Mexican restaurant, the establishing shot tells us that the restaurant's name is Escapimos en su alimento, which in English means, we spit in your food. I've watched Anchorman 100 times and never picked up on that, so I don't know whether that's good or not. Number 4. Captain America's shield is in Iron Man. You know when an Easter egg is super cool? When it can shift and move with the times. Marvel proved they knew how to do just that when it released 2008's Iron Man. While the shot of Captain America's shield among Tony Stark's pile of junk is nothing new to most people's ears, it takes on a whole new meaning when you realize what Marvel was building to. Before we were attacked with comic book hero films each and every week, Iron Man was somewhat of a novelty, and that's exactly how people reacted to seeing the shield too. But it wasn't. It was more than this. It was a nod to what was about to come, the Marvel Cinematic Universe. When you take that into account, of course the shield would be there. It's pretty cool. Number 3. John Landis has a secret film. John Landis is incredibly talented, but John Landis may also be a little bit crazy. Having a hand in the likes of the Blues Brothers schlock and Coming to America, to name a few, he also has a secret movie, See You Next Wednesday. Now, you can't see this film, you can't book tickets, you can't read a synopsis online, it merely exists in Landis's head. But he's so infatuated with it, you can spot a reference in nearly every one of his movies. Appearing in the form of a poster, billboard, and sometimes even said out loud by a character,
"See you next Wednesday."
It all started when Landis heard the line mentioned nonchalantly by someone in 2001 A Space Odyssey.
See you next Wednesday.
And then this crazy stuff started. So now you know. Number 2. Every Pixar movie is hidden in the previous one. This is madness, this. As if it wasn't hard enough to make an animated film, people at Pixar decided one day, screw it. Let's make our lives loads more difficult. But yeah, every Pixar movie contains a reference to the Pixar movie that comes after it. For example, Nemo pops up a couple of times in Monsters, Inc. A shadow of a dog in Ratatouille is Doug from Up. A kid is reading a Mr. Incredible comic in Finding Nemo, and there's a drawing of Sully in Brave. It's nuts to think they would do this once, but every movie is a testament to that studio. They're all in. Number 1. Back to the Future is just one big Easter egg. Back to the Future already has a ton of Easter eggs and secrets that most people know about, but look even deeper and you'll just keep finding more. For example, one of the best is when Doc asks Marty to meet him at the Twin Pines Mall to test the DeLorean. After Marty has traveled to the past, he finds himself on the farm the mall was eventually built on and, as we know, runs down a very specific pine tree. Then what happens when we're back in the future? The mall is now simply called Lone Pine. That's genius! It's not like this is the only thread coming off that one scene either. The farmer whose pine tree Marty ran over is called Peabody. And guess what? He has a son named Sherman, which is an obvious nod at time travelers Peabody and Sherman from 1960s cartoon Rocky and Bullwinkle. They literally thought of everything. So there you have it. Secrets that are just waiting to be discovered and blow up your brain. Know of any more? Let us know in the comments below, and then don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. I'm Simon from Whatculture, and I'll speak to you again soon.